Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Tiptoeing with Primals, where we're going to take on, if you are familiar with the location, Garuda Easy Mode, or Normal if you prefer. I'm in pretty much the same stuff I was in before for my last few videos. I got some ethereal mithril stuff from Stone Vigil, the Boar's Bane I still have from way back in the Sunken Temple of Karn. Armor I got from Quest that I need to update this one. I think that's the only extremely up-to-date one I got. Double check. 38, 69. I don't even know where I got those. Yeah, so that's all up-to-date. Quest bar. Oh, I can't summon my pet here. I want to summon my minion. I've been making idle chit-chat with this guy while I got ready for this. So let's see. Party up. Stone Vigil to... Whoa, where is she? The Howling Eye. Join. Do the registration complete. I did an instant pop. That's fascinating. So, I'll see y'all later when this actually pops. Hey! Commence.
Light party.
Because this is Garuda easy or normal, not hard, so it's only a 4-man. Oh, actual plot, hold on. Ah, damn, okay. I'm back. I'm letting them talk, because it's a moment. They're kobolds, those are Ifrit's lizard men. Wherefore come you hither? That's some speech. Hear me for I am. I'm intimidated, I'll admit. Fraps! No, stop. Bad fraps. Nasty noises. I'd actually want to see that fight. I got shivers. I'm scared. That is... I just want to stop and listen to the music. I like that. That's right, time to Alright. I'll figure out on the fly. How complicated could it be? I'm a tank. So this is a simple combination to get up my storm's path so that I'm not taking a whole lot of damage. I want to back myself right up to this rock. Hey, I'll put on Fracture. I don't use Fracture. Alright, main is about to wear off, so put back up main. Get nice healed. Not seeing... Oh, that was a cleave. Not seeing anything too complicated. Slipstream, which... a cleave. Okay. Alright, and line of sight. And back here. And then being it. So I have a party. I have a Dragoon. I have a White Mage, and I have a Summoner. I don't think I can grab those plumes. So, DPS handle that. I'm going to actually remember to use the fact that I have infuriated so I can interbeast her. I'm kind of just beating up her. Ooh, that stunned me. Interesting. I'm doing good on threat, which you can see overall threat bars over here. If they're less than half, you're doing fantastic. And this is my fifth combo move, so Infuriate, which allows me to enter Beast. Alright, and she's gonna take to the skies, which she's gonna land somewhere, and I just have to land inside her. That's not too complicated. Or else you take the damages. Come here. I'm gonna huck tomahawks at you, because you're all the way over there. She do. Come here, you. Yeah, I can't even tank the blooms. They will not come to me. Okay, back up my main. Back up. What is that? Storm's Path? Haha, I know the name of my abilities. Not really. Skull Sun. Come on, Deeks. Kill them plumes. Up here comes Slipstream. Stunning Cleave. Our rocks are looking a little low. The reckoning rocks. Ow! That was intimidating. No hope, none, she says. Come on, hit her with Storm's Path. A pocket of calm within this. Alright. Stay in the middle. Alright, I'm getting low. Time to hit some buttons. Which for me is... Mistral's Song. Ow! I'm guessing I'm supposed to try to dodge that. I don't think I was supposed to soak. That was a limit break. Okay, am I supposed to grab those? I think I'm supposed to grab those. There's enough of them to make me think I'm supposed to grab them. I wanna focus. I'm not gonna use the Skull Sunder combo anymore in the Butcher's Block because I'm taking a lot of damage and Storm's Path heals me a little bit, which helps mitigate some of that damage. Every little bit counts. Ow. Ow. And I'm dead. I wonder what happened. Nope, we're down to a Dragoon and my heels. For what that's worth. The Dragoon's gonna try! So what am I missing in the Eye of the Storm segment? Forward! That was interesting. Oh well. Still got plenty of time. So good. Oh god, the music one. I don't get it. I don't get that. Do I have to try to dodge it, or am I just soaking it? oh. Well then. You know, I'm level 44. I'm like under leveled compared to these guys. Again? It's like the rocks we got long enough. I know the rock mechanic. I'm gonna put my back right up against this wall of air. I know you can't see much when I do that, but not seeing much is kind of the thing's job. You have to see, you have to position yourself to see nothing. Yet at the same time, keep an eye out on the entire battlefield. You're the tank. I mean, you have to. It's like being having a pet class, where the entire party is your pet. Wish I was kidding. Yippee. Cool. Gotta get behind a rock. Come here, yo. Yeah, I can't tank those. They go and bugger off right away. So overall, this isn't a too exciting fight to tank. I'm sorry, but as a tank, what you do for this fight on easy, you hold the boss to a side and soak damage. I mean, I could tell you rotation tips, but I mean, if you watch kind of what my the little blinky on my bar down here, you can kind of see what it is anyway. That's heavy swing, skull thunder, butcher's block. I mean, I don't really need to overpower or flash any because I can't tank the AoE. I can't tank the adds. They have no aggro table. Oh, Ko got hit. Hey. I need that. Stop beating on my rocks, Garuda. I need those. Crabs keeps freaking out. So the video's gonna be really choppy. But I'm having fun and I want you guys to share in that. Come on, come here. The rocks have names. Get low. Okay, not so low. Thank you, crit. That guy crits really little. Kill the balloons. Let them destroy our rocks. We need those. slipstream. Yeah, I got stunned. Alright, the reckoning comes, so she'll kill her ox, which is gonna hurt a little. Ow! Okay, so that hurt a little. And now I don't take her to the wall. My goal is just to keep her kind of off to one side, but at the same time, I don't want to get too close because then I'm getting hit by the tornado. That was an inner beast that I hope keep me alive. Inner beast for 5 seconds significantly increases. Oh, okay. I have to sidestep that. You have to sidestep that when she does it in this phase. And I guess that makes sense. Not really, no, but I guess. I mean, I can't do anything about slipstream. Oh god, if the Dragoon was up, he could limit her right now, and it would be great. It would be okay. Oh hey, the Dragoon is up! Hey, he limited her! Top us off, top us off, top us off, top us off! Top me off? Okay, we're down to tank and heals. Dead. In the eye of the storm segment. Try to break for level 2. The rocks will die. The Eye of the Storm segment. That's hard-coded. That's definitely her coach. She just smashes them. Alright, we're getting that wrong. We're getting that right. Boss, kill the boss, kill the boss. Far from a glorious one-shot, but hey, I'm learning, you're seeing how I analyze fights, at least. I do have some prior knowledge from the fight, because I did watch Nakato Ely's Dancing with Primals, which it has the owl. Maybe I should try to run through her when she does that. Okay, where's she landing? She's landing on top of me. Gives me plenty of time to get back here. Or not. That hurt a little. That would have wiped a raid if this was a raid. The Wicked Wheel! When she slipstreams, I'll try to run through her and see if that stops me from getting hit. Because that could be a lot of damage I'm taking unnecessarily. I can! It's an unmarked round. Ooh! I learned something! That's important to know. That could be crucial for tanking the hard mode variant. so I can avoid that. That's important to know. And I have to watch your taskbar to tell that, up here. Because it doesn't have an AoE on the ground. Mind my hotkeys. I get away from her before she... Ah! It's our auto-run. That is so dumb. I didn't know what my auto-run button was, because I never use it. Looms! Looms! Get behind something! She does that. Oh. Hey, I dodged something, that's cool. Back up lane. I'm trying to keep my commentary... I'm trying to talk slower for this because I notice I tend to talk fast. At the same time, my mind is running at 1,000 miles an hour on what to do. What do? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, get to run through her. Ow. Ah, I failed. Okay, where'd she go? Alright, the reckoning comes. So that's it for the rocks. Gotta give my raid as much room to maneuver as possible. Don't stack. Because she has an AoE that will hit nearby enemies, so you don't want to, or nearby allies, so you don't want to stack. Get behind her. Yes, then she does that! I wonder if that works during the rock phase. You can use that to dodge the rocks. Oh, I should have run through her. She slipstreamed. Taking a lot of damage during this part. Come on, get. That is an awesome skill he keeps using. I want to know what it is. Help me. Okay. I don't know where my limit break button is. Limit break! I need to remember where my limit break is because I could have limit breaked her. Where is my limit break? Okay, my limit break is there. One more pull. We got this! Come on, guys! Mana! Got this. Says the kitty tank. I should not make a noob mistake. I should put on Defiance. And I need to put Unchained here. I am going to need Unchained. Psyched! Let's go! So, Unchained is set to 9. I need to remember that. For that final phase, that is a DPS check if I've ever seen one. And, that 20% DPS can make the difference. kill. Believe it or not, when you're a tank, 20% of your DPS could make a difference. Went through. I think got hit. Yup. Okay, where is she bouncing down at? Oh, Ko died. I'd say that's a wipe, but we're not on any particularly hard timer. So what is that ability he keeps using? Because it looks awesome. So because we lost the DPS, I'm going to press some buttons to hope my heal gets him up in time. I'm not getting healed. Oh, our heals DC. Heals DC. It's all right. Heals DC. I'm typing, and I can't think and type at the same time. I don't have vote kick rights, which is weird. Tank should always have party leadership. But that might just be me being a... Yeah. I'll be back in a minute when... we pull, and I teach Ko how to MMO. Be back in a minute. Alright, it's been a little chaotic, but we finally have a party where pretty much I'm the only person who didn't cycle out. same instance. It's just, the healer's DC'd, so I got a healer from an LS that I chill in, or a link spell I chill in. I'm talking fast again. And while we waited for her to come back, both DPS ended up leaving and joining. So now we have two bards and a summoner, as opposed to a dragoon, two bards and a scholar, as opposed to a dragoon, a summoner, and a whitmage. And I need to remember to dodge slipstream. It's like I can't keep my eyes off a Caspar. That's never fun. I don't like just watching her Caspar. I hate those fights. I hate those fights more than anything. This would be a team that can really kill the Blooms, because bards have good ranged AoE, whereas previously we had a Dragoon, who has good melee AoE. But... Slipstream. But the... But it's melee, and they kind of have to chase. Bards can just shoot. Is whatever. I like this rock. This rock is like the only indicator of what side of the field I'm on. I have determined it is down, because the enemy base is down. Actually, I've yet to see the Ender's Game movie. I've read the books. I really like the books. Me and my friends just have a nice, long discussion about the books. Good books. If you have not read the Ender's Game series by Orson Scott Card, I would recommend it. Read all of them, too. There's like 8 or 9 books. The Reckoning Comes. Aerial Blast. Argra Tornadoes! Get Eye of the Storm. There's no escape. No hope. None. You're like, there's no hope. No escape. None. Oh, I should have unchained there. Instead of, inner beasting. Alright, and which way is she gonna face? Oh, that's right, she always faces me. Tenorel kicked himself out into the tornado. Now, unfortunately, because we have two bards and... Gotta dodge Slipstream. Alright, so I haven't used Inner Beast before. Apparently, it's not on my GCD. And now I hit harder. In general. And there we go, because bards kick ass. Go bards, go bards. There we go, there's the plot fight with Garuda. Fun times. That was loud. I've done it before. Is she still dying? And just not feeling it? Oh no, her... She's drawing power from her people. Okay. She doesn't like that plan. She's... That's a god I could respect. That is honestly something I can respect, actually. The idea, hey, you're actually giving me power, I will use it to protect you. That's a very benign concept. This is a neat little plot sequence. I'm not sure if I should be showing you this. Because it's plot, like spoilers, but it's a let's play. And at the same time, it's an MMO. You can't temper me. I'm protected by the MacGuffin shield. You should be mine! It's not fair! Why can't I have nice things? Bitch, please. That's mine. I will be taking it now. Have a nice day. Sleep well. Have nice dreams. I'll see you in the 7th Hell. Meanwhile, mine. Crystals. Hey, I have all 6. I wonder what that means. Let's find out. I kind of regret not recording like all the major cutscenes throughout the game as a full let's play, but it's an MMO, and I was just kind of playing it on my own for fun because I was bored, and I got it for myself for Christmas because a friend of mine got it. And I mean, I've had this for about 2 weeks now, and I'm level 40 some odd. Oh gosh, I've had this for about 2 weeks now, which means I'm almost out of time. Oh well, I'll figure out a way to continue my subscription. This game is fun. Worth it. Hey, Sid. Yeah. I got it. Alright. So there's that. There is no loot for the fight. Just plot. Because normal. When you do hard mode and extreme mode, there's loot. So, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time for more Let's Tiptoe Around. Eventually, well, you might start dancing with Primals on Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. I'll see you all next time. Thanks.